Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to tell you how to use variable data with Adobe Illustrator. So this would be using something like a Google Sheet or an Excel sheet. And today we're going to use Google Sheets because everyone has access to that for free. All right, let's get started. Okay, so first we'll set up our document. I want this to be a 1200 by 470 web image. So I'm going to go to Create New. We'll come up here to Web. And in pixels, I'll just have this be 1200 by 470. And we'll create. First, I'm going to add my background by going to File Place. I've got all my backgrounds in the same folder. So I'll place that. Now we're going to add in our first piece of variable text. So I'll hit T on my keyboard and click once, and I'll type in networking. Get back on my selection tool and grab a corner and hold shift and make it a little bit bigger. I'm going to change it to white. Now we'll come up here and choose Oswald, and I'll just make this a little bit bigger. Now I'm going to add a rectangle underneath, just make that white, and maybe we'll make it just a little bit bigger. And now I'll add my second piece of text, which I'm going to use area type because this will be a lot of smaller text. And for this text, I want it to be Montserrat. We'll do regular and a little bit bigger, 15 points. And I'll just paste the actual text in. And I'll go to paragraph and dehyphenate so we don't have all the little hyphenations in there. Okay, and now I'm going to place another image over here, and this will also be a variable image. So we'll go to File, Place, and I'm going to choose the first one that I have set up in that folder. Yeah, I'll just put it right here and move it over a little bit. Now, best case scenario, all of your backgrounds are the same size, all of your images are the same size, and it'll just switch them out with the spreadsheet. So otherwise, sometimes things will overlap and you'll get kind of weird results. So I really recommend making everything the same size starting out. So this is what our design layout is going to look like. And now we'll go to Window Variables. So to set it up on the Illustrator side, first we're going to click on this word, and then we're going to click on this bottom button here, which says Make Text Dynamic. So now Illustrator will kind of know that this is something that's going to be coming in from a spreadsheet. And we'll do that for all of the other pieces that we're going to bring in from the spreadsheet. So I'll click on this text box and click that. I'll click my background and click the same button. And as you can see, it shows a little picture and a linked file because Illustrator knows that that's going to be a picture now. Then we'll click on the other image and do the same. All right, and now it's time to set up our Google spreadsheet. So to do this, we're going to use this variable one. So I'm going to copy that. We'll come out here to Google Sheets, and I've already got one set up as variable data. You can name it anything you want. And here is where we'll want to paste that variable one. When we go back to our Illustrator document, you can see we've got variable 1, 2, 3, and 4. And you can keep these as variable 1, 2, 3, and 4, or you can name them whatever you want. I usually just leave them as the variables that Illustrator puts in. So across the top, we'll need variable 1, 2, 3, and 4. And if you are using images like I am, you will need the at symbol in front of the ones that are images. So we'll add that to C and D, which are our background and our image. You can see that here. Our variable 3 is an image, our variable 4. So they absolutely have to have the at symbol. Otherwise, Illustrator won't know that they're an image. Now you'll want to type in all the info for the two text fields. So we've got networking here and the text that goes with networking. And I'm going to just paste these in, but you, of course, you'll just want to add them like normal. And then I've also got text in another document that I can just paste in right here. Now for the image variables, we'll have to actually tell Illustrator where to find those images. So we need to go out to our Finder. My first image is the BG01. That's the one that I actually pasted into the Illustrator file. So to get the information on that, I'm going to click on it and then hit Command-I. And then it'll say where. I'm just going to copy all of this information and then go back to my spreadsheet. I'll double click in the first networking area and paste it in. Now you'll notice that it does not get the file name, so we'll need to add that manually. So we'll add a backslash and then bg01.jpg or whatever it is. Okay, it's PNG. I'll just hit return, select all, and copy this to make sure it's exactly correct. I'll just delete all this and paste that in. So this will be the same on these others, but with the other file names. So I'm gonna copy this and we'll just paste it on down here. And now we'll go in and change the file names to match. They're just 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And we'll do the same with our other images. I'll just hit Command I, I'll copy this, and then I'll add this file name to each one. So we'll do backslash, I'll copy that and just paste it in here. We'll fill out the others with their file names. Now I do want to mention, if you're on a PC, you cannot have any spaces in your file names. So all of this cannot have spaces, but it doesn't matter on a Mac, it'll still work correctly. All right, now that we have our whole spreadsheet done, we'll come up here to File, Download, and Comma Separated Values, or CSV. I usually just leave it in my Downloads folder, but you'll probably want to keep this with all your other files for this data merge. Okay, let's go back to Illustrator. And now in our variables, we'll want to click on these three little lines and Load Variable Library. And now we can go to our Downloads with Option Command L. I'm going to sort by recent ones, so I'll hit Command 2 and choose Date Modified. And then we'll choose the variable data and we'll open. This says it already contains variables, and do we want to overwrite them? Yes, we do. It shouldn't really change anything because all of these things are still the same as the one you put in. It'll be pulling from that first one, so it'll look the same. So now we can click this little drop down by the data set and choose which one we want to look at. Okay, so we've got different text here, a different background, and a different image. And you can flip through all the different ones right over here with these arrows. As you can see, we probably should change some of these. For example, this one kind of bleeds into this area. So if we do, we can just resize this. But just know that if you do that, and if you move it around or do anything to that, when you go to your next data set, it will have updated on this one too. It'll update across the board, which that can definitely be a good thing, but it's going to depend based on the data set that you're changing. Okay, so now if we want to export these, we actually have to create an action for that. You can't just export as a PDF, it'll only export the one that's on your screen at the moment. So let's go ahead and set up an action and I'll show you how to do that. So go to your actions, that'll also be under Window Actions. I've already created this, so I'm just going to trash it. You don't necessarily need to do a new folder here, but you'll need to create a new action right down here and then record. Now I want these to end up as JPEGs, so I'm going to go to File, Export, Export As. I'll create a new folder. I'll call it Done. And I'm going to export these as PNG and I'll use the artboards and we'll export. I do want it to be screen resolution. Background color can be just white, it doesn't really matter because they all fill up the background. So we'll say okay. And then we'll stop our action with this little square at the bottom of the actions window. Now we'll come back up to the actions flyout and choose batch at the very bottom. So it's going to probably automatically load the last one you did. You can see my set here is variable data and it's action 3, which is the one I just recorded. Under source, you'll need it to say data sets. Yours will probably be set to folder, so you'll need to change it to data sets. If you chose an export action like export as JPEG or export as PNG, you'll want to choose this bottom one. If you're doing a save as action like EPS or PDF, you'll want to do this action. Since I chose the export one, I'll choose this one, and then I'll choose a different folder, and I'll choose the done folder. Also, I want the file plus the data set name, and we'll say okay. So now it's running through all of these different ones and it's saving them out there in the done folder. Okay, so let's check to see if it worked. Okay, so here's the done folder and it has all of them. Now it's going to save your file name, which I didn't name it, probably should have. And you can see all the different versions that the merge made. So it worked perfectly. And that's it. This will work really great if you had hundreds or thousands of entries in a spreadsheet and you can make all the different designs just in a few clicks. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell beside it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out, which is every Thursday. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.